The Devils' first pick in this draft came in the second round. He joins us now, Steve Santini. Steve, congratulations. One goal achieved. You have many more ahead, but congratulations. Just talk through the process. What's going through your mind as names are called and you're waiting for yours to be announced?
Well, it's definitely nerve-wracking. You're sitting there like almost praying, is it going to be me? Is it going to be me? So when I heard my name by the Devils, it was a great feeling. You know, I got a warm welcome from the crowd, and it was a very nice moment for me to share with my family.
You're a local guy. You're from Westchester, New York, so you're familiar with this area. How did you get involved in hockey?
Actually, my dad was my first coach. He played for the University of Maine from 83 to 87. So having been in the game, he got me started at a young age, and I just fell in love with it, never looked back. So I'm very lucky.
Was there anything else that tugged at your heart along the way, or was it always hockey?
I played baseball and football growing up. I played baseball right up until I went to the U.S. national team. So I played there for a very long time. I love hockey, and it's my passion. So,
as you mentioned, you go to the national development team. So you leave Westchester, you go to Michigan, you go to Ann Arbor. Not an easy choice on the one hand to make. On the other hand, very important and obvious one to make to further your development. What was the thought process there?
Yeah, well, it's never easy leaving home as a 16-year-old. But I have a good good family and a good support group of my friends. So they all supported me and told me to keep working hard along the way. And, it's brought me to this point. So I'm very blessed.
You're obviously well-spoken. You're poised. You're mature. You are described as a guy who's awfully rough and tough on the ice. Do you turn it on just before you hit the ice?
Yeah, I get that a lot from people. I'm kind of a different person on the ice than I am off the ice. Off the ice, I try to treat everyone with respect, and I'm very religious. That's a big part of my life. But on the ice, I kind of leave my personal life in the parking lot, sort of say. So I am tough on the ice. It's part of my game, being competitive, working hard. But off the ice, I just try to do the right thing and be a good person.
Growing up in this area, and we know you've talked about it before, you grew up a Rangers fan, but that lasted until your name was announced by the Devils. Who did you grow up emulating, if you will? Were there people that you said, you know what, if I can get to the National Hockey League, that's the style I want to play?
Well, definitely as of late, Brooks Orpik and Mark Stewart, two American defensemen, kind of like me. Very hardworking, very competitive, responsible, reliable guys. So those are two guys that I definitely kind of looked up to, definitely in recent years. If I can be like them, I'll be very, very happy.
You mentioned off the ice, you played other sports until you decided to dedicate yourself fully. What else do you do for fun?
I like to read. I read the newspaper every day. I like to hang out with friends. I like to train off the ice, go swimming. So, I like to do a lot of things.
Now, you said you read the newspaper and you read the newspaper frequently. Do you read the newspaper, or do you read it online?
I read the newspaper. I get the Journal News to my house every day. I read the regular, and then obviously I read through the sports section, but it's just part of my routine now. I want to know what's going on in the world of sports and life, so it's a big part of my routine, yeah.
Well, I can speak for my colleague Sherry Ross, who spent many years in the newspaper business, and guys like Rich Scher and Tom Galitti, who cover this team for the Newark Star-Ledger and the Bergen Record, respectively. It's important to buy the paper, so they'll be heartened to hear that you actually have the hard copy in your hands and it's not the freebie online. So where do you go from here?
I'll be at Boston College in the fall. I'm just going to work hard and do everything it takes to make it in the Devils one day. Playing in the National Hockey League is my goal. This is one step. However, there'll be many more steps along the way to get better and wear a Devils uniform in a game.
Steve, what are some of those steps?
I'd like to make the World Junior team at some point. And I'd also, like to do well at Boston College and get better there. Every day is a new day, so you got to get better every day.
The statistics show lots of assists, no goals. Is there a story behind that? Is it just a matter of that's the way it's gone and eventually they'll come?
Yeah, I'm not a big stats guy. Anyone that'll tell you, I'm a team guy. I block shots. I kill penalties. I'll, shut down opponents' top forwards. I've had a few shots this year that were tipped right in front that were probably going in. So the guys on my team are giving me a hard time about it, but it doesn't bother me or affect the way I play, no.
You may have grown up a fan of the Devils' arch rival, but clearly you know what the Devils stand for, and it is defense. It's from goal out that they have established their reputation. So in many ways, you fit into the organization's philosophy.
Yeah, well, obviously Mr. Lamorello has done a great job here in New Jersey, and I'm a big fan of what he does and how he does things, and I'm very excited to hopefully one day have the opportunity to play here.
You interviewed with the Devils during the combine. I think you mentioned 22 teams. Yes. Maybe I'm off on the number. Okay, 22 teams. What is that process like? I think it's a mystery to almost everyone who's not involved. Can you kind of pull the curtain back a little bit on what goes on in those interviews?
Sometimes you hear crazy stories about getting crazy questions and stuff. But for me, it was pretty basic, kind of repetitive. They just ask, you know, where you're from, what's your family life like, how do you like playing for USA, just kind of stuff like that. Just a 15 or 20 minute get to know you talk, see how you conduct yourself, and you know how mature you are. But I, you know, I never really got asked any hard questions or anything. So
they just ask the basics. Do they probe a little bit? Do you think there was something hidden behind some of the questions?
I don't know. It's tough to say. For me, I mean, I didn't really have a problem with the interviewing process. No teams really gave me a hard time, so I just enjoyed it and made the most of the week out there.
You can't go wrong selecting Boston College, one of the elite programs, but why the Eagles and why not some of the other great teams that play in the NCAA?
Well, I really like the campus. It's a great school academically, and obviously they've had success the past few years. I really like what Coach York and Coach Brownie have done there. So I just thought for me as a person, a student, and a player, it would be a great fit for me.
Well, there's a terrific Devils connection to Boston College, too. The Gianta brothers, Peter Harold, Scott Clemenson. So that kind of fits the profile, too.
Yeah, I obviously know that they've had a lot of players go through there, and I think it'll be a good fit.
All right. What was the it moment for you, you know, where you thought, you know what, I'm going to make this commitment. It's not going to be another sport. I'm not going to stay here in high school. Was there some moment that kind of opened your eyes and said, if I focus, I can do something important in the sport?
Yeah, when I was around 11 or 12, I was kind of one of the best players on my team. A lot of scouts come to watch you play, and you kind of realize, you know, there was a moment for me around that age that I was just like, you know what, I'm just going to go all in and work as hard as I can. I'll shoot pucks, eat healthy, work out, play hockey. So I just did everything I could to get here, and I have no regrets on anything I did.
You mentioned your dad obviously had an awful lot to do with it, having played the sport, et cetera. Was there a push and tug at all, or was it always like, you know, he was the guy who really knew the answers?
My dad was very supportive of me. If I wanted to be a baseball player, he would have let me be a baseball player. But like I said earlier, hockey is my passion. It's a full-time job for me. I take it very seriously. And, my dad and my mom and my family, my friends, they've supported me with that. And, I've had every opportunity to succeed up to this point.
Well, Steve, you're obviously enjoying this moment. We know there's much more to do today, and get out and share it with your family. Congratulations, and we look forward to seeing you wearing the uniform for real one day and playing here at Prudential Center.
All right, thanks a lot. I appreciate it.